have Jen read it. Okay. The question is, I was wondering if you could contribute some information. I have been craving beets insanely. Cut, canned, I eat cold or heat them up, add a dash of butter and a ton of garlic salt. I eat the cold ones and the garlic salt too. Now I went through an adrenal crisis the last 2 years because of my pituitary shutting down from an old brain injury causing an infarction. So now I'm doing a lot of replacement hormones for life, not comfort, and I have Hashimoto's thyroiditis and suffering since I was 13, which means I take a Levoxil and I'm in chronic pain because of the accident that impaired my brain, like the RF on my spine. I posted some pics, this was on Facebook, in December. I'm just posting this public to share in case it helps other people. So any ideas why I'm going crazy for beets and garlic salt? I'm having 1 to 3 cans a day. I eat them for breakfast, a snack, can't get enough. Next week I'm going to experiment with raw, fresh, and beet greens.
So what I'm going to have Jen do is she's going to look up on, you're going to go online and you're going to look up beets. So what people do are crave particular minerals or vitamins. Women that were pregnant before would sit there and eat dirt. And the main reason was is because they craved a mineral that they couldn't find in their daily environment. So they would go and find it another way. So beets we're going to look up as soon as she finds something. And there can be also a spiritual meaning, which we will go and look for. What I need Jen also to do is open Dream Moods. So like we'd look at the nutritional contents when she looks up regular. And what you're looking up for, sir, Scotty, is to take and look up what Hashimoto. And so it'd be H.
And if it's not under that, it was thyroiditis.
Right. So we're going to try to see if it's there.
Hashimoto's. So in beets, what kind of information did you want?
Just nutritional value. And chances are it is a specific, beets are, I think, are really good for the liver to help you process. And one of the things is if you're taking a lot of hormone replacements and you're taking a lot of medication, your liver has to process out all of the stuff that it needs to process. And when your liver can't process too well, beets really help out in a very wonderful way. And as far as all I can say is look up what beets can do. I think it was just for, like, main thing was for the liver. I can't remember if it was the processing or if it was a certain.
So do you want me to look up medicine as far as what it has been used historically to
why
treat?
Yeah, why don't you do that?
Okay, so the roots and leaves of the beet have been used in folk medicine to treat a wide variety of ailments. Ancient Romans used beetroot as a treatment for fevers and constipation, among other ailments. Apicius in De Ro Cocinaria gives 5 recipes for soups, given as a laxative, 3 of which feature the root of a beet. Hippocrates, thank you. The doctors take the Hippocratic oath. Anyway, sorry. Advocated the use of beet leaves as binding for wounds. Since Roman times, beetroot juice has been considered an aphrodisiac. From the Middle Ages, beetroot was used as a treatment for a variety of conditions, especially illnesses relating to digestion and the blood. Platina recommended taking beetroot with garlic to nullify the effects of garlic breath. That's interesting. It has been suggested the pigment molecule betanin in the root of red beets may protect against oxidative stress and has been used for this purpose in Europe for centuries. All parts of the beet plant contain oxalic acid. Beet greens and Swiss chard are both considered high oxalate foods, which have been implicated on the formation of kidney stones.
Also, in energy work, the kidneys, the two little tubes, I cannot remember the names of them now, but one processes chemicals and one processes funguses and viruses and things. So if the medication is not, is piling up and not filtering and flushing out, then it's also, they're saying beets is good for the kidneys. Mm-hmm. Okay? And so that's a good thing. So you're craving it because your body knows right now what it needs the most.
Especially with the information on that medication. Mm-hmm. That was part of the question.
Now, you have to understand that the adrenal, the pituitary, okay, and the thyroid, these are your, my mind is drawing a blank. They are your glands, the glandular system, and each one of them are related to a chakra. So they're different consciousness and the different way that there's, you know, are you collecting the data, where are you stuck, what's going on. And because there was an injury, one of the things they're trying to point out to me is in the thyroid, because there's a lot of thyroid problems represent this, infantile Tyrannosaurus. Their experience is that I never get to do what I want to do. When is it going to be my turn? They are the product of convenience, concerned parenting, in which giving in to their whims was the line of least resistance. They ended up believing that they are going to be and constantly denied their fair share of things due to the necessity of having to cooperate with a larger picture in life. They decided to have, they decidedly have no concept of that or any intention of participating in the give or take of life. Now, you have to remember, if you're an adult and you're thinking, I do those things, I give and take, we're not talking about the age, because that's your chronological age. We're talking about the younger age of when this set the domino effect. It's those moments that I'm unable to process. So now what I'm going to do is I'm going to look for particular reading of energy. And then what we're going to go from there. Okay, so we're not looking for a healing tool, we're just still looking for what is it about. You know what it's like to be bullied. The first time you knew it was this is a really strong past life. Okay, so then you brought that over and what, inside the womb? The beginning of consciousness. Alright. Now, you got to understand, a bully will always take and hurt, and you'll never have your turn. The reason for the brain injury happens to be that you were supposed to be suppressed. Again, that's one of the things that bullies do, is suppress. The particular of why you can't create your own hormones, because it was taken. So there happens to be feeling like there's a loss. And it's the way that you're identifying and knowing it. You have something physical, you can say, this is it, this is it, this is it. To break it down so the body can start to repair itself, some hands-on healing would be good. Maybe a homeopathic or two that would help with the connection. Now, the chronic pain is that you have to remember that the reason I said hands-on healing is because energy medicine, I would tell you to go ahead and look for Donna Eaton, look for energy medicine. It's very important to understand that touch for health, anything to do with the meridians, when the meridians are stuck, frozen, not moving, congested, too fast, too slow, will cause you physical pain because the energy is literally doing something other than the flow. Donna Eaton tells you how to sedate and strengthen certain meridians. She teaches you how to trace and to flush and to balance. She had, I think it was MS, and she learned to just keep tracing her meridians every day and to rebalance her meridians every day, to the point where her body completely recovered, because it was like building a muscle again. Right now, your body is holding a particular memory. Another thing I would have you do is do hands-on healing. Go to somebody that has cranial sacral, or any other person that has particular healing techniques. She had had car accidents. Jen did.
Galore.
And one time, remember how we sat into my office, And I just said, okay, we watch TV, and I put my hands on your head, and we just started to trip the fascia, which is, if you understand, you're engaging in that mesh, very strong mesh field, and that basically holds these memories that you, it's like, for instance, if I hit the bottom of my elbow, you would think there would be pain in the elbow, but it will show up usually at the fingertips, and you'll have problems in that area. And if you are engaging with the memory, and you have, especially when we had you recall,
yep.
And as we had you recall, what it does is it brings it to the surface. Now you can also look for an emotion code practitioner, because what they'll do is they will have you do certain things and they can help your body release it. Once you bring it up, your body will bring it to the surface and the magnetic energy will release it. You can do some healing tools yourself. You go to Medicine Woman, that's with an A, Medicine Woman, the number 4, the letter U.com, and look for the emotion code under the healing tools, and that'll give you a short little thing, a chart that you can use, and then it'll lead you to his Dr. Bradley Nelson's website and the book, so that if you wanted to do some more self-help for yourself, I believe I got Donna Eden's information on there, but I don't know exactly which healing tool I have it under. Several of them, I think, but you can have relief because the pain. Now, there's several other things because you know the pain, and they're saying it's not because of just the brain injury. Yes, it's the energy backed up. Is there any trapped emotion specifically that's causing this pain? And they said, yes, it has to do with being wishy-washy. What does that really mean?
Indecisive, not really committing to something.
Or you commit to something and then you switch.
Change your mind.
There's nothing wrong with that.
Yeah.
It's just a particular thing that your body does, your brain does, because something is not flowing correctly. Something is stuck, a first experience. In this case, this emotion stuck.
It's kind of like when you go to a restaurant and you're looking at the menu and there's just all those options. And, oh my gosh, overwhelmed. I don't know what to decide to do. I like this.
Well, what's funny
like that.
Is that I think she's an empath. And the reason why I say that is because some of this energy that I'm feeling are not even hers. Now, I'm not asking you to blame, and I'm not telling you to blame. I'm telling you that if you start to know what is you and what is not you, then you can actually stop to take it, and I'm not going to take it on anymore. There's all different kinds of things that you can do. I have a homeopathic, or which I call a soulpathic, and it is for grounding, and it's called the Guardian. And basically it helps with the energy so that your body can start holding those patterns, and so you don't really have to take and be an empath so strongly and pick up the people in the environment, because you may draw those type of people into your space. What else is there? Many more things, but take this and just start to learn to, you know, one step at a time, write to us again, you know, call into one of our shows, you know, we'll do our best, or you can just call and make an appointment, and we will go ahead and set it up, and we can help you start to relieve the pain. You had pain in your shoulder the other night?
Yeah, last night.
And the scale from 0 to 10, the pain?
Today is like, maybe, it's under a 1.
But last night, did we work on it?
Yeah, last night we worked on it, and the pain was pretty intense. It was around a 9 or a 10.
And then when we worked on it, did the number come down?
Yes.
Okay.
It took a while. I also know I did some healing in my sleep, but as we're working on it, it did start to relieve. And
because it was related to one of her big issues about how her heart's been broken. And so she had other layers, and so she had to go to, I usually wait till you get down to 0, but this is a huge one for her, so we just put the golden white light in place of it.
And I made the promise
to heal later.